these trips, I had to go and get a passport. I'm just trying to live, I don't know what these buddy mad for. I just signed a deal and got a really big backport. Still at your mama crib, ain't getting money, you gotta ask for it. I'm tired of complaining, I gotta bitch change my situation. Looking at the view outside, I thought I would never make it. Every day these petty pay, but that don't stop the money making. If you want it, go and take it, ain't no point in hesitating. I don't wanna be on the ground when the time flies. Had so many friends go, I wonder when it's my time. I live every day like I'll die by the nighttime. It took me so long getting back to my right mind. I don't wanna be on the ground when the time flies. Had so many friends go, I wonder when it's my time. I live every day like I'll die by the nighttime. It took me so long getting back to my right mind.
Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Work it hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my numbers going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You say that you ballin', keep it real though. Why I never saw you in the field though? Hey, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
Big numbers, 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team yeah. Got it, that's a big number.
Hey, foreign cars, foreign seats with the foreign leather. Foreign number, put the card in the ATM in the sad era. Yeah, flex mode, this ain't Southwest, this a jet. I ain't gotta shut the cell off, cause the iPhone don't got a jet mode. Bad. Pesto. If you wanna come, let's go. We ain't going nowhere special. I just wanna see Modesto. Hit you throwing, I'ma catch those. Mexican, dummy pesos. Hit you sus, I'll replace those. Number save, no name though.
We need more, tell them we need more. Put numbers on the board, let them keep a score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet points of God.
Big numbers. Big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team count it, that's a big number.
Yeah, wrist man, check the wrist man, got him hot. Man can't ball like this, man, Lord. Pass the
high fingering.
Here's Prater now set to kick it away.
What's up, Herpes?
This is taken about 7 yards deep. Yeah, he'll take.
Are you talking to me? Oh.
No.
Mm-hmm.
What happened to that message I sent you, buddy? I sent him a message saying, what are you playing?
This is David Johnson, the former All-Pro.
I'm still waiting for my grandma's
spot. They'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Oh, okay.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback. And no better way to do it than to establish
a running
game
early.
On second down,
oh, broadcasting?
It's Johnson, and he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line.
45.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short.
If I go on there, it's better than
play action.
Yeah, without a doubt, I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Devon Kennard. He's the culprit, causes a loss of 5, and it brings up 4th down.
Yeah.
Fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away.
Okay,
back deep, Danny Amendola.
About that, I've only known
him. I'm watching his broadcast right now.
Fielded just inside the 20.
Rosie's my friend.
Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Lions will take over.
Oh, my God. It just finally said 1 next to the people watching.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
Internet connection speed went back.
A look at Kerryon Johnson, second-year man out of Auburn. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37.
Oh, shit.
Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down. To throw on 2nd and 6.
Stafford.
And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Corey Peters slipping in and getting the sack. After the sack, Stafford and the Lions come up on a 3rd and long situation. And that is incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces 4th down. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked out at about the 3-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
Him.
On 2nd down, Johnson. They'll try to get forward, but he's going to be stopped in his tracks at about the 3. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd down. 2 runs for a net gain of nothing. Now here's 3rd and 10. He's got a man complete. It's Clay. And this one will be taken up. They'll spot it right at the 7. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down. Here's Andy Lee now as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time.
Which means fuck you.
Here comes Amendola. A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
That's a damn boot.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You got some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
Let's see if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. A first down carry here for Johnson. And Johnson lost the football. It's loose, poked out. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Damn. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
So good field position for the Cardinals as they come up first and 10. Following that fumble recovery, it's Murray. Flushed out right. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Murray. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Christian Kirk, the man he was looking for, and it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Throwing is Murray on third down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Trey Flowers, the former Arkansas Razorback, in there to get him. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
What's that? Say vagina?
No.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do?
Hey, mamas.
Get it to their best
player,
y'all. Right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, okay, and try to move the football.
Easy on that one.
Looking to throw again on second down. Stafford. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 16 yards, a first down.
Shut up.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. We're scoreless after one. The Lions with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a first and 10. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Stafford going to give this one off to Johnson. Give the tackle to Hassan Reddick. For these two franchises, the Lions and the Cardinals, it all began back on a Sunday in October of 1930 when the Chicago Cardinals visited Portsmouth, Ohio to play a scoreless game against the hometown Portsmouth Spartans in front of 6,500 fans. 4 years later, the Portsmouth Spartans would move to Detroit. Anyways, 90 seasons later, after some rebranding, a couple relocations, one of the oldest rivalries in the NFL still lives on. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 7 yards there and a first down.
It's a damn mess. She put some kind of hex thingy on me already.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Great game.
From the gun, a run for Johnson. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
On second down, it's Johnson, and he'll get it down on the play to the 37.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Damn, y'all still finishing.
Ladies, 43, tackles,
They'll run on first down. Johnson. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. First down, Lions on a pickup of 13. Stafford on first down. Flush to his right. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 7 yards on the play, and it'll bring up a second down.
Oh, my.
Johnson on the counter, and he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. It's a first down following a gain of 3.
That's a tremendous group effort there, because when you talk about offensive lines, the best ones, talk about guys that play in harmony, in sync, and getting things done, and they did that on that play.
Yeah, especially on 3rd and 1, got to be in sync, and they were. Now a first down throw, Stafford. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Danny Amendola, that was the intended target, but it'll be 2nd down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Now, meanwhile, here's a 2nd down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Danny Amendola, the man he was trying to get it to. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. Now Stafford. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he will not be able to get the first, as he can get this only down to the 5. Give him 8 on the play. And that's going to bring up the 4th down. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half.
Yeah. Not gonna lie, they're kind of good. Hell no.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get 3.
It sounds like you're going negative on that.
I was.
It sounds like you're thinking
I
3
I
is just not that
anything
good.
Cold.
And people say we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the 3 is good. Obviously, you were thinking a 14-play drive to get the 6 out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on, because you might wear the defense down.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. The results for them so far, not that great.
Well,
not good at all. 3 drives, 3 punts.
And now what you're doing is you're looking at your play sheet, trying to figure out what you're going against defensively. I wonder, are they showing them something they haven't seen or anticipated in practice, and maybe that's throwing them off?
Oh, my God.
Or do they just have to go to a different play calling section and try and run some offense that way?
From the 24, they'll go again on 2nd and 10. There's Murray escaping the pressure right.
I don't know.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here, because they didn't completions on 1st and 2nd down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the 1st down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
And that last penalty makes this 3rd down play a little more interesting. 3rd and 5. From the gun on 3rd down, Murray eluding the pressure right. Looking deep for Crabtree. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down. Here's Andy Lee now. He's been terrific so far. Amazing, perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Hooked up by Byron Murphy, the rookie from Washington. He couldn't hook up with Amendola there. After the turnover, here's Murray. He rifles one that's intercepted.
Wait, what are you playing right now?
Picked off by Tavon Wilson. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. Andy Isabella was the intended target. So the first interception of his career under center, and you knew it was going to happen sooner or later.
Of course. And I know he feels like the world is just tumbling down at this moment, but there's got to be some veteran somewhere, some mentor that's going to tell him, hang in there, my man. Plenty more to come. Keep firing.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, my nose is playing.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Dang.
To throw again, Stafford. He's got a first down past the 30. And finally taken down at the 36-yard line. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. So from the 36 now, first and 10. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
Stafford now to throw. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
So your mic is static, so bad.
Faking the give to Johnson. Now it's Stafford. He's going to rifle one deep left. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick.
And every time it stops, just a little bit
shy of midfield at the 48-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Now Murray, flushed out right. This one complete to Christian Kirk. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number 1. I can't believe they didn't let you play. Fake handoff to Johnson. Now here's Murray. He'll buy some time right. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number 1. From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. Flushed it, and he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald. As the first half is winding down, and the Cardinals have taken the lead. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Dawson tacks on the point after, and that makes it a 7-3 lead.
Eli, you have...
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Ooh.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this early back to the 20. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Time here for likely a couple plays if they want it, but with a field position what it is, maybe better suited to just sit on this one?
I'm with you totally. I would sit on it and get into the locker room and start over.
That's all I have
but
to say.
If they do decide to try and make a play, we know what the basics are.
Right,
you run
draw,
you run screen. I would maybe run a little swing pass and try and get my lineman out in space and see if they can chop a hole into the secondary and see if he can run a little bit.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half.
Off.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. Ooh. And the decision to come out is going to cost him. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
They're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. First down at Stafford. He'll find a man over the middle. It's Galladay. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Brings up second and a yard at the 48-yard line. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Out of the pistol, here's Johnson. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks. From the gun on third down, Stafford. And that will be incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just 1 target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
And now on fourth and 1, it's a fake. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool this defense. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Second and 10. At their 48-yard line.
On second down now, it's Johnson. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line.
When you think of Mike Daniels, you think of strength. Hard to knock off the football, but surprising quickness and ability to move and evade people. How about that play there?
Well, he can squat 600 pounds, so that's how he caught people's attention coming into the league, and he caught our attention right there.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. From the 26, they'll line up on second and 4. To throw is Stafford. The left side completion to Jones. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Well, if you do read man covers, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
On first down, Johnson. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Now it's Stafford off the bootleg.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that,
this is taken in. It's complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 41-yard line. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off around the 37. There he goes, right side. And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And it's a big advantage of it when the other direction. Excellent blocking and picked up a touchdown.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. This would be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, it didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it.
And got his man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That's good for 28 yards. Back to throw, Stafford. He's got his tight end over the middle, T.J. Hockenson. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. If you're thinking of a comeback here, you go to 2016. That's when Stafford had an NFL record 8 fourth-quarter comebacks. But last year, despite playing all 16 games, he had 0. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. He was trying to find Marvin Jones that time. That'll bring up second down. Throwing again. Stafford. They'll roll him out right. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Again, it's Stafford. And it's intercepted.